You've been trying to get that special family recipe right in the oven, but even when you follow step for step, it never seems to come out cooked to perfection. If you don't have a thermometer on hand to make sure the oven is pumping out the right levels of heat, here's a quick tip to help you figure out if that dial is telling the truth or not. First, set your oven to a crisp 180 degrees Celsius. While you wait for it to heat up, take two pieces of aluminum foil and fold them over into little miniature makeshift pans. Now that you have your pans, add one spoonful of table sugar to each of them. When the oven is up to temperature, put the first sample of sugar in for 15 minutes. When done, pull the sugar out and reset your temperature to 190 degrees Celsius and give it some time to catch up. Once ready, place your second sample of sugar in the oven and give it another 15 minutes. If your oven is properly calibrated, your first sample of sugar should stay white and granulated, and the second one nicely browned and melted. If both are brown, your oven reaches a higher temperature than you set it for, and if both are still white, your oven isn't getting as hot as you think. Regular table sugar is 99% sucrose, which is usually extracted from sugarcane or sugar beets. Both of your table sugar samples begin to break down and decompose through a chemical transformation process called caramelization. And in addition to caramelization, sucrose melts at a steady 186 degrees Celsius, that sweet spot between our two oven temperature experiments. So sweet, in fact, that now you know if your oven is a little hot, a little cool, or right on the money. Alright folks, as you probably figured out at this point, we love finding new chemistry life hacks. So if you happen to have any old chemistry-inspired tricks or tips that you use at home, post them down in the comments. Make sure to check out these other two kitchen tip life hack videos to make your life a little easier with all the evidence you need to back it up. We want to give a big shout out to Jeff Potter, who wrote Cooking for Geeks, the book that inspired these kitchen chemistry hacks. Get out there and get yourself a copy. A link's down in the description. Thanks for watching, folks. Hit subscribe and thumbs up on the way out, and we'll see you again very soon.